All right. So I have the talk of my new book. It's taking me a while to get it out there because of I'm having this flattening problems. But anyway, I did it. I didn't flatten it actually, but we'll see. Maybe it's acceptable. But it's called Stones of the Gods. Now, Stones of the Gods. Now, I'm talking of Corsica. I'm talking of a time of Zoolatry when they worship gods that are animals, specifically. So we have, like well, they still do in India and other places. They have Nandi, who is the god bull, and they have the massive statue of the god of the bull, and people give flowers, and they give gifts. Then we also have who else? We have Garuda. Garuda is Shiva's beautiful, often portrayed in golden, like a golden bird underneath Shiva. It could be a raven. It can be a swan. But yeah, that's my technique. Shush. My technique, that's my deal also. But what I was really yabbering on was, then there is Naja. Now Naja is a snake. Now the snake is a serpent. And normally in folklore and in mythology, we have the Naja fighting the Garuda, and the Garuda fighting the Naja. Well, this particular place is Stones of the Gods. They have so many birds there. Well, there is a Garuda there, okay. And so then they have also my little dog. See, all of this happened before I knew about the mythology of it. My little dog died, and I went there to chirp the other dogs, and so we went there. And then there was this little tiny hedgehog stone that looked just like her. And I'm like, oh my gosh, it's a Naja stone. And so there she is, she's a Naja stone. And then I went back and I read about it, and I find out that it's a Naja god, that Naja deity, meaning the one who also had, you know, lifetime of turmoil with this Garuda. So we have the Garuda and the Naja back and forth, the tug of war. And very interestingly, I don't know if I got that story through, but very interestingly, we have this hedgehog, the Naja god, which I named indirectly. I didn't even know this, and she ended up being there on Garuda's beak, which is just hysterical after all of these years. You know, it's just hysterical, like haha. You know, I end up on the beak of Dantadian, you know, after all the years of fighting and competition. The trouble is it's so small. It's a very tiny, tiny little creature. So it's not the serpent of the past that it's been used to in folklore and mythologies and tribal discussions or whatever. Yeah, it's not anything like that. It's more like, I hope nobody takes her, because she's very small. But yeah, so when we're talking of that, because when we're dealing with Shiva, we're dealing with the animals around, and this zoolatry where the deity of these animals, where they are worshipped, they're revered, they're respected above and beyond this mundane work, domestication, and overdone ordinance that's happened since the time of the Romans. Okay, I'll say the Romans, I can't really pin it to the Greeks, but I probably could. They got really, you know, into their juror syndrome. So they're like, well, okay, judge this and judge that, you know, and then they start forming their civilization that ended up close to the Greeks, anyway, as close to the Romans anyway, close enough. You know, it was another government, another big government, you know, happening. So one big government made another, So where we're at with that, so so I was trying to tell you my Shiva deal, how easy it was. Like if you ever had like a beautiful dog, you ever had a beautiful cat or a beautiful rabbit, I mean, it's easy, you know, to think of yourself as like, well, if you did have a big, beautiful dog, you think of yourself a little tiny self, really small. And then you put yourself in your meditation state, you put yourself there on the back of that little dog, or the big dog, rather. So you're a little, like a little tiny, tiny, a bug. You're just a bug on that dog. But you try not to bug the dog, you try not to hurt him or upset him, you just try to be there and enjoy the journey. Okay? So that's what I'm talking about as the Shiva deity helper there. So it is a like a life meditation state. You do it every day. When you wake up, you do it when you go to sleep. It never goes away. You are in that particular meditation state. You can change animals, of course. You can say okay, you know, but sometimes maybe not. Maybe you get stuck on the back of the duck that you once knew that was so beautiful and soft. And that's that. You know, what's wrong with that? What's wrong with being stuck on the back of that beautiful god of a duck? There's nothing wrong. What's wrong with being stuck on that beautiful god of a dog? Nothing. Now, remember, you're small. You're small. And so their little feathers or their little fur, my gosh, they can almost shield you, protect you from the wind and the breeze. So it's this type of a situation. So when you're getting up there, when you're getting up that high, then it's fun. But then, on the other token, you know, I understand you still have a grievance state, you still have the stage of angers, you have the stage of dishearteningings. When you have all of those things going on, you have to actually take yourself back to the animal itself. Take yourself back to that duck, take yourself back to the main deity there. So if you were the raven, if your raven was your companion animal, well then the raven itself, then at some point you are the raven, you know. You have to understand, because that is there is the fight there. The raven still is the one who fights. The duck is still the one who has fight. You know, just like Naja and just like Garuda have their fight. There's that moment. So when you fall off, essentially, your human Shiva, when you fall off your human Shiva, you can say, well, I'm just in the animal jurisdiction moment, the moment when the animal itself is having its turmoil. So now the turmoils we're having, oh my gosh, the turmoils we're having, obviously they're not the same. You know, you can't say, you know, there's a big serpent outside and I'm trying to slay it or anything. It's not anything like that, but it is a figurative serpent. It is a figurative aggressor. And it's an aggressor to you. It's an aggressor that you have. Now, it can be an internal, or it can be one that's, you know, from other human beings. You know, that you keep getting more and more. You know, let's say I have, like, myself in particular is a Roman. The Roman deal is pretty heavy. You know, I'm like, well, let's just change this and go. Just say it didn't happen, you know, this last 3,000 years, and let's just go back to Zoolatry, and let's just do that. You know, this is much better treatment of the animals, more sanctimonious human beings, much more higher chance for peace all around the world, and less take. So all of this is becoming more and more a conclusion. So the Roman state is that serpent out the door. The Roman state is that group that the Garuda has to fight, is the one that the Rook has to fight, the duck or the dog, you know, that deity dog. Now, you can choose any deity you want. You can have your Nandi, which is the great bull. You can have, I don't know the one for the, they do have the horse. I don't know. It's easier if it's been a pet of yours. If you've already had the pet, you already know how it feels like. It's better for the meditation state, because it just, it wheels and deals in your brain, and you go zonk. You know, yeah, I know exactly. You know, I can be that little tiny, momentum character on that main animal beast, because it is still a main animal beast. All right. So, anyhoot, I don't want to overdo the chore of you all having to put up with me. But what was the name of it? Stones of the Gods. Yeah. Now there are other books under a similar title, but yeah, nobody took this one so far. So it's pretty cool. I have Stones of the Gods, and I don't know. Yeah, it's quite a place. It's quite a place there, and all of the. What do you call it? The idolatries, the deities. It's anthropology, it's paleontology, it's the other thing, archaeology. It's all there, and there's fossils way back to 70,000, maybe 100 million years ago. Yeah, I didn't mean 1,000, million years ago, and huge heads, caterpillars, butterflies. Not the butterflies that I could see, but the caterpillars I could see. So, yay. Anyway, yeah, land of the lost, almost. Yeah, that experience. Anyway, yeah, I'm a little hyper. Doing all this work. Anyway, that's the thing. So we're dealing with the Shiva deity animal and zoolatry. Okay.